So what you're looking at is the personal injury marketing systems and the order of effectiveness. And that's after, opening 77 offices in 20 states and being highly aware of the difference between publicity, advertising, and educational sales. So these are what I would say that the personal injury marketing systems that are most effective, and I would say also the order of effectiveness. So the first one is going to be the most effective, the second one will be second effective, things like that. And so I would say that these would be the top six personal injury marketing systems that are most effective. And number one is always the personal injury attorney educational sales. That's always number one. And remember the big difference between publicity, advertising, or sales. The big difference is if you control three, if how many of the three core components of a purchase you can control, manipulate, or affect, which is perceived need, relative to the obstacles, relative to trust. Those are the three categories that's going to determine a purchase. And so advertising does allow, or excuse me, publicity only will cover, is primarily used for trust. That's what publicity is used for. Only really one of the three categories. Advertising is really primarily used to diminish the barrier to entry, which are the obstacles. In addition to that, you can try to influence need or trust, but that's not, it's, with good copy, that's what good copywriting tries to do, but no way near what the human experience can be. No way near. That's like a video, an educational sales video on a website will always, with, and even if it has the exact same content as sales copy, will always do better in A/B testing. That's the power of the personalization, the video, the visual, that kind of thing. So advertising really is geared toward advertising is geared toward the overcoming the barriers. So it's in the minimizing the barrier to entry, and typically that's time or money. Typically that's discounted offers, things like that. So that's advertising. And then educational sales, when you're skilled, it can do all three. And so educational sales, again, by far will give way more business than publicity or advertising. When you know how to establish need, eliminate or minimize the obstacles, and increase trust, that's when you get a lot of business. And of course, we'll go into the pros and cons of each of those, because you're talking about different knowledge levels and different time levels. If a doctor doesn't have the knowledge or skill, and he doesn't take the time to do it, then he's stuck. He's stuck and very limited in advertising, which is a very small percent. So educational sales, that's why educational sales always is number one.